Well, good morning, DCO Nation. Welcome back to the channel. Appreciate everybody tuning in. This morning, we are in Murrells Inlet. Sorry about that. I heard some fish going off behind me here, so hopefully that's a good sign for today. But this morning, we're in Murrells Inlet, and we're going to be fishing the last couple hours of the outgoing tide, first couple hours of the incoming tide, and we're going to really target a little bit of everything. Some flounder, the flounder are in. I was out yesterday, caught a couple flounder, and so maybe I can pick up a redfish, a trout. Guys, we're just gonna kind of paddle around and enjoy the day. So I appreciate y'all coming by, and here we go. All right, y'all, let's get going this morning. Fish are busting all around me. So this is a ZMan Diesel MinnowZ. It's a 4-inch paddle tail. The color is Opening Night, and I've got a 3/16 ounce Texas eye with some mullet procure. And we are gonna work some of these shorelines here, and because I am just seeing all kinds of activity right now. There we go, guys. Fish on. Fish on here this morning. Let's see what we got. Who came out to play? Small little flounder. Oh, he spit it out. All right. See, that's what I'm talking about. He won't be a catch, but awesome. Little flounder. Boy, you can just see all the birds working this bank here. There's a lot of activity going on in this little creek. A lot of nervous water up in there. There we go. Fish on, guys. Fish on. Yeah. What do we got? I'm going to keep some pressure on him. He feels like a flounder. Yeah, flounder. Stay down. Whoa, he was not ready. There we go. Small little flounder. Ooh, shake off all the water before I get him in here. Good. That nervous water over here. Ended up picking up a small little flounder. Small little flounder. Let's throw him on the board. Let's just take a look. I'm guessing 10 inches. How about 11 and a half? All right, 11 and a half. Here we go. Little dink. He's out. Okay, cool. All right, so we got the one that we lost this morning, and then that little 11 and a half. So, all right, we're on a little something here. So, y'all, this is why I like fishing low tide, if you guys don't know. All the water is out. There is nothing up on this bank and this grass. So all of these fish have to come to the water, have to be concentrated down in here. That's why I love the last couple hours of the low and the first couple hours of the incoming, because when you get into high tide situations, these grasses get flooded and these fish have a large area to spread out in. So guys, my preference is low tide, you know, that middle part, the last part of the outgoing and the first part of the incoming. That's what I really like. So, you know, there are good high tide fishing spots, you know, up onto the flats, but this is what I prefer. Obviously, not every time I can get out, it's going to be perfect conditions and the tide's going to be right. But this is, when it does line up, this is what I like right here. Looks like there's something right over here, guys. I'm going to get the little Vudu shrimp out here real quick and pitch up right over into here, because it looks like there may be something in here working. Let's pop him right over here. There we go. Something's on it. Something's on it. Yeah. There we go. picked him up. Another flounder right out of here. Stay on. Yeah, guys. We're on a little something here. Let's kick that bale open here real quick. Yeah, you can see. Wanted it. Here we go. All right, y'all, one more look. Another probably 11, 12 inch flounder. Oh gosh, kicked water on me. All right, so that's two smallies, but we're looking for mama. And you can see what he ended up doing to my little voodoo shrimp, taking the tail off. So I am going to change him out real fast and put another one on and work this area. Gonna go back to the Diesel MinnowZ opening night. Start searching around again, start throwing. I gotta be getting close to low tide if I'm not at low tide right now. So that's probably why the bite has kind of turned off, but I have been successful picking up flounder during slack tide. I just had a little hit. There we go. Fish on, fish on. Yeah. Something just thumped it. Nice. Oh gosh, guys, big old flounder. Big flounder. I'm not gonna horse him. I want him to stay down, but boy, this is a nice fish right here. Woo! Okay, take it easy. We got time. It looked like he was hooked pretty good. Yeah. Big flounder. Nope. Not quite ready yet. Not quite ready. What you doing? I'm just gonna wear you down because I've got you hooked pretty doggone good. I got him, boys. Woo! That is a slab. He may go 20. Yes. Patience pays off. He may go 20. All right, guys, I got my bogus on him. Look at him. It's a nice fish. All right, let's put him on the board here real fast so we can just take a quick look. All right, guys. Best that I can measure right now, he is tipping 19. Probably, no, let's call him 18 and a half. 18 and a half inch slab. He is a keeper in South Carolina. But like I always do, I always let him go. I'm gonna get a good release back on him. There, he kicked off nice and strong. All right, nice fish right there. Beauty. So opening night seems to be the color today. So I've got three flounder and I lost the one, my very first one, right at the kayak. Oh, we are not going to change. So the diesel MinnowZ and opening night. That's what we got, guys. Slack tide. I have more success with catching flounder at slack tide than, you know, redfish and trout. Redfish and trout, I believe, really like the current. Not to say that the flounder don't like current and water movement, but you can still catch fish at slack tide. Little long creek drain right here. Pulling way out. A little bit of activity around here. I don't know if you can see that creek drain right there. It's what I'm kind of working right now. There we go. Fish on, guys. Fish on right there in the creek drain. And stay with him. Reach back, get the net, keep some pressure on him. Woo! Another solid flounder. Another solid little flounder. Yeah, I see you. Nice. Again, pulling right off of this little creek drain over here. There was a bunch of bait fish working. And what was it, three casts? Four casts out of there? Great. Again, probably only, I would say maybe 13. But right on it. Right on him. Good. Nice to see him. There you go. Later. Hey y'all, so let's go ahead and end this video today. The wind is starting to kick up a little bit, so I'm gonna go ahead and push on off. I had a good successful day flounder fishing. The first one, if you want to call it a catch, I lost it right at the kayak there, so I was just kind of bouncing that little paddle tail. The opening night was definitely the color today. That's what they wanted. That second and third flounder, they were at some creek mouths, and I saw some bait kind of busting and moving there on the surface, and so I pitched up into there and I ended up picking up some flounder. And then the big flounder, the 18 and a half, he was also at a creek mouth, right on like a little point of the creek mouth there, and ended up pulling him in. And then the fourth or fifth final flounder was again at a creek drain where I saw some bait fish being busted on the surface. So guys, today, definitely creek drains, creek mouths, wherever there was bait and birds, that's where the fish were. So that's what I was keying in on, and it seemed to be a pattern for success today. So guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you learned something. That's why I kind of put these videos out. But the big flounder are back in Murrells Inlet. So guys, if you have a chance, get out here. Spring is here. It is a beautiful time to be out on the water. Best way to help out the channel is subscribe. Like the video so that it gets pushed out to other people. Share it with anybody who is into this kind of stuff. And guys, I really appreciate each and every one of you. I will see you out on the water. Have a great day.